Educational and Education Day. From the book of St. Luke.
Amen.
Dr. Luke. The 11th chapter.
All right.
And I'm going to read this morning. From the New American Standard, you will see on the Trinity Vision, the Holman translation. But there are six verses here that will act as a companion for you to take your magazine as well as your Bible and what you visualize on the screen with these words. And he said to them, suppose one of you shall have a friend. And shall go to him at midnight and say to him, friend, lend me three loaves.
All right.
Amen. For a friend of mine has come to me from a journey. And I have nothing to set before him. But am from the inside, the seventh verse says, he shall answer and say, do not bother me. Because the door has already been shut.
All right.
And my children and I are in bed. And listen to the next from the American Standard. I cannot get up
Lord have mercy.
And give you anything. Why? Because the door is closed. Have I got a word? Look down at the 10th verse. It says, for everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks, it shall, what shall? The door will be opened. 13th verse says, if you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those, Sister Hannah, good to see you back, to those who ask him. Would you take with you for the rest of your natural life these words? How does a believer open doors in life? I hear, you hear constantly that the door is slammed in front of my door. I hear, particularly from our culture, they just won't let me get into the door of opportunity. On educational days all through this month, churches are saying about the doors of opportunity are open to you if you, in fact, stay stay on, study, and keep on progressing no matter what. Don't quit. Stay in the path of moving on. Amen. So I would like to spend just a few minutes with you talking about what is there that's going on in the text. Luke 11, we've heard it many times, where ask,
see,
and knock on the door. But before we go and celebrate the next Sunday in June, I want to know, right along with you, what is there that the Lord is impressing upon us as believers? Is that how to get a door? Have we got a witness? The graduates, you should be, if you're going towards a vocational opportunity this summer, or if you're going after graduating with your bachelor's, the master's, the doctorate, if you're going into the career and seeking a career, you should be asking me, how do I get in the door?
Amen.
Those of you who don't have jobs right now, your prayer, whether you are asking me or someone else, is the Lord, let me get a foot.
All right. All right.
In the door.
Amen.
Have we got words? Amen. So I stop and look to see, particularly after the events, after 9 o'clock in Charleston, South Carolina, and Emmanuel Church, Mother Emmanuel, I stopped and asked the Lord to show me where he has shown us a way to get past the door.
All right.
Yeah. Even when they don't want to let me,
all right,
because of the color of your skin. Even because fathers, some fathers, say that I just can't handle the expense, the load, the burden.
Yes.
So I run off.
Yes.
Because of their vision of everything being blocked up against them.
Yes, sir.
Every road that seemingly they go down, they find the door
closed. Lord have mercy.
And then our Father, our Lord,
yes, sir.
And looking down.
Yes, sir.
And I don't know why he allows people to put a closed door in front of me.
Huh. Lord have mercy.
Because I'm a believer.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why the evil person and the evil father seemingly has more than I ever could think of. And I'm spending time in a schoolroom on Sunday morning. I should be out making my way. And as Brother Jones said, is that the devil will tell you that this assembly and this when you should be spending your time as for the devil in getting in the door. Christ.
All right. Yes.
Because the other things pays for.
Lord have mercy.
Many other things when you don't have to put up with bad attitudes.
Amen.
You don't have to put up with situations that you don't want to put up with.
Yes.
But God said,
God said,
you let me handle those. And you have to go back and do it. This is your family too. And as we become a close and a solid and a united congregation, is that the Lord will not only favor our existence, he will give some grace. I've got a witness. He'll give continued and extended mercy. Won't he do it? Is that as the disciples got closer and as they loved each other and spoke to each other and didn't stand back in their little clustered situations, he blessed them. But you won't make it any further than where you are.
All right.
Until you exercise the spirit of prayer.
Amen.
Look at this verse. I know. I get it. The reason why I don't do it, diverse distractions are not ever to be discouragements. The devil knows, and that word diverse is a word that says various. Various distractions will get you and me off the track. And we got a witness. Ask, what do you mean? Well, there's some people, including myself, on some days, that the least little thing can get you off. Amen. In fact, in one of my psychological courses in a graduate school, we were talking about how to assess your workers and how to know and understand their readiness, is that we sat down and looked at facial expressions as well as attitudes to determine whether that person should be approached or not.
All right.